OpenSpace offers an automated 360 photo documentation solution. We do that by taking an off-the-shelf 360 camera, mounting it to your hard hat using one of these magnetic mounts, and pairing it with our mobile phone app for iOS and Android. Think of that like a remote control, ultimately a start and stop button in your hand rather than top of your head. OpenSpace is a software then takes all of the photos that these cameras are capturing and automatically pin it to your floor plan using our vision engine. So that process looks something like this. Strap your camera on, hit record, and walk. It's very much that simple. The output is then something like this. This green squiggly line on the right is a path you've taken as you've walked around site. Think of it as OpenSpace dropping digital breadcrumbs as you're walking around. And then on the left, you've got this beautiful 360 degree view, just like Google Street View, of what you've captured on site. So if we jump into a project, you'll see here, if I click my mouse and drag, we'll have that full 360 degree view, just like we would with Google Street View. If we look up, we've got ceilings, down we've got floors, we can see it mounted to our friend's hard hat here. If we want to start walking around, we can use these blue rings to jump room to room or point to point. We can also use our floor plan to navigate. Simply open it up, click on a point, and it will drop us straight in there. Now I like to show you our timeline buttons down the bottom here. So these cameras are taking a picture every half a second. These buttons allow us to flick through every single one of those frames. So if we're looking for something in particular or a certain point in time, it makes it very, very easy to do that. Next, we've got our date picker tool, and this allows us to go back in time. So if we want to see the status of a room maybe 2, 3, 4 months ago, this allows us to go back and have a look at a snapshot of what the status was like back then. Now, blocks that are darker blue are closer to my location currently. The lighter the blue, the further they are away. Grey blocks mean there's data, but on a different floor or sheet. So if we jump into one of these, we'll see that it takes us back a couple of months, and we can see the difference in status. The next kind of step to this is our split screen tool, where you can then compare today versus this past date. So we can just whip forward very easily, put the two side by side, and see what's changed. Now, if we want to go into more detail, we have the ability to raise field notes. Field notes are these floating sticky notes, which allow you to snap a picture of a location. It will automatically pin your location to the floor plan, but what it will allow us to do is then write a description, set a status or priority, so how quickly this needs to be sorted, set up an email alert list, so we can add members here, so every time anything is changed or updated, these members will be notified. We can then add tags. All of these are customizable, but this will help with the reporting side of things, which I'll go through in a minute. Things like due dates, which will also show past due when the date has passed, and things like comments to keep that very important audit log, so you have name, date, and timestamp every time someone mentions anything in this thread. And then finally, down the bottom here, we can also add attachments. For instance, this is to do with pat testing and electricity, so we could attach the electrical spec sheet to this to ensure that we have all the information required to make sure this is a success. The great thing about field notes is they're then all stored down the left-hand side of your project. So you'll see here we have 11. If I very quickly just wanted to look at the electrical problems with this project, I can quickly filter it down to 2 and find the information I'm looking for very, very quickly. To take this one step further, if I wanted to, I can report on these issues and pump out a PDF report to share with my sub-teams or specialty contractors on this project. So the report will come through as an email. I simply click the link and it will open up as a PDF. We have a nice cover page with the title that we gave it, who prepared it, and the dates it was captured between, names of project and things like that as well. This is the cover picture that would have been placed on the start of your project. You then have this nice report summary, and so this will be broken down by different priorities, different statuses, and also tags. So if you remember, I selected electrical, so we've got a couple of electrical here, but also one of them had multiple tags, so equipment and electrical. We then have all the electrical issues on one page, all the equipment issues, and then we have one page per issue view with all the information associated with this particular issue. So a large image an overall map view and a zoomed in version just to show exactly where it is. But my favorite part about these reports is that they are all hyperlinked back to OpenSpace. So if you were to hand this to a contractor, they could simply click here and it would take them back into the project to show them this particular issue in context. And so then it removes the problems where, oh, I went to site and couldn't find the issue. This shows them exactly where it is and what they need to fix. One of the last things I like to show in our core product is our BIM model viewer. And so if you have a BIM model on your project, using the Autodesk Forge integration, what we're able to do is upload your model very easily into OpenSpace and be able to align that with your captures. The Vision Engine does this automatically for you, so there's no heavy lifting on your side. You would simply come in, upload your model, and then once it's aligned, when you log in, this is a view you would be met with. And one of the things I love about this is that it enables people who aren't used to using a BIM model the ability to be able to walk through it easily.